crested lintel sitting on the dais. Delegates, students of the different departments, graduate and postgraduate students, I first welcome on behalf of the center. My lecture is related with the new dimension, new domain in the remote sensing technology survey. I will brief you about the remote sensing, the data, the satellites, and the data satellite program, what we receive from the satellites, how we interpret the satellite programs, and then what is the new dimensions, new domain in the satellite technology. Now, first lecture, first slide, please, Sangat, I think you will help me. Next, this is the, if you see, these are the two orbits. If you just see, there are the two orbits. One is the subsynchronous polar orbit, and other one is the equatorial orbit, where the geostationary orbit and the satellites are moving in the two directions. First one, which is the geostationary satellites, they are the communication satellites. They are moving at the height of 36,000 km, and what we receive through our mobile from DTS transmissions, these are the basic basic features is available with these type of satellites. Next is the remote sensing satellite, which are orbiting from north to south, and they are the satellite which captures the photograph on the earth surface. And now we are using these satellite photograph for our remote sensing purpose. So these two basic differences are there. One satellite at the 36,000 km and other one is the 7 to 900 km, which is called remote sensing satellites. Next. This third one is the GPS satellites. Now if you know that we have the mobile, we have number of things where we are using the location services, the GPS enabled smartphone also. We receive the signals from these GPS satellites. And these GPS satellites are the constellation of 24 satellites on the orbit, and moving 4 satellites in each plane. There are 6 planes in the orbit. Now you can very well understand, these satellites covers the entire globe. If you are sitting on anywhere on the Earth surface, you are carrying your mobile or you may be your GPS instrument, you will get the signal. So this is the third one, and these satellites are located at the height of 20,000 km. India has a capability to have its own satellite system, which is called NAVIC. You must be heard about this name by Prime Minister, that India is self-capable. He has launched his satellites. This is a constellation of 7 satellites, and this covers the 1500 km along the Indian border. So this covers is the GPS satellites for Indian plate, India and adjoining areas. Third one. Now what happens, actually this is based on the cameras are based on the sensors are based on the visible infrared, microwave, and these are the band, we call it a band. Now the cameras have the sensor has the capability to capture the photographs. Now you just see this, there is a small black dot is there. This is called the visible band. That what our eyes are capable to see. That means we cannot see anything if it is not in this range. Our eyes are capable to see in the visible range. Next. These are the some satellites, and this is called the resolution of the satellites. The capability of the satellites to capture, to see the object on the ground. And India is capable to see an object of 1 meter by 1 meter on the ground. And where the foreign satellites have a 30 centimeter resolution, they are covering. Next. These are another set of satellite photographs which I am showing you. These are used for different purposes, whether it is a soil, agriculture, forest, or any type of applications, whether smart city development, infrastructure development, these are the satellites. This is a basic what I am talking about today, is that there are 3 types of satellites, and the sensor and the satellite photographs. Next. Then comes the Indian microwave satellites, which is called RESAT-1, 2, RESAT-12 is the name of the microwave satellites. This has the capability, the sensor has the capability to penetrate on the ground, to see beyond the cloud range, and we can see ground through these satellites. And these are the India has a capability to this type of satellites. Next. This photograph shows, just see the first one in the optical data where we are showing the cloud on the sky, and the other one is the microwave data when we are seeing the floods dominating areas in the along the river, which can be captured by the these microwave satellites. Next. Then comes the software, which is called a GIS software. This is called Geographical Information System. And this software is used for the interpretation of this entire interpretation of the vector layer and all information. We overlay all these satellite photographs, we put and draw polygons and do analysis on the GIS platform. So basically is a GIS is a tool to digitize, to analyze a system and analyze the satellite photographs. Next. These are the satellite photographs, and I think you can clearly see the different color, different features which shows the how we are interpreting the satellite photographs. See, if you have to see a salt affected area, if you have to see a water body, and these satellites are showing exactly, if you just see that, what is the urban areas. Now if you want to plan any urban city, you want to plan any smart city, expressway, we can use these satellite photographs and give a clear cut route of the these features. Next. Similarly, this one again is the mining area which is showing, industrial area. Lot of things, how we are interpreting, because each satellite have a photograph, each photograph is have a own texture, color and pattern of the features which we interpret to identify a particular object. Next. These are again, I'm showing the forest area, where the forest area, how it looks, how it looks in the satellite photographs. Next. Next. Again, this comes the Lucknow city area, which is a cartosat data of Lucknow city. We can see the buildings. This is a 2.5 meter resolution satellite photograph of the cartosat 1. Which you can see the Lucknow area, the Gomti river is passing in between the city area, and we can see each and every building on this satellite photographs. Now if we have a master plan for any Nagar Nigam or any purpose, we can make use of the satellite photographs to identify the building objects. Next. Then comes the GIS mapping is used for the different purposes, for road, for railway line, for canal, for buildings, river line. These are the interpretation we are using this satellite photograph to draw this type of line. Next. Then comes the waste disposal site, urban water drainage plan, the storm water management, location based attributes, metro network, tax property assessment, GPS based services. These are the new domain in the remote sensing technology where we have to work now. We have got a lot of inputs from the satellite photographs, and the requirement from the state and the center is very much, and these are the new areas where we can have to work. Next. Again comes the satellites with the earthquake monitoring. Next. Again is the flood monitoring, where you see the Kedarnath bar, where we have used the satellite photographs to map the Kedarnath TSD. Next. Then the drought areas, we can make use of drought areas and disaster area. Next. Then this information is available on our website. Our website is fully showing the different type of flood layer, a current flood layer of, if you see it today only, the flood affected areas on 9th August is also available on our website. Currently we are putting day basis, on day to day basis, we are putting the information on the website. Next. Now, next comes the LIDAR technology, where we are using the new technology, which is a part of the geospatial technology now. And the LIDAR is the system where this is the equipment we have bought recently. And if you just see, there are three type LIDAR systems. Well, one is the mobile LIDAR survey, airborne UAV LIDAR survey, and the terrestrial LIDAR. We have got the mobile radar system, we have got the terrestrial radar system, and we the UAV based system, we are also in touch with the state government to have a UAV system in our office so that we can do a lot of monitoring with the unmanned aerial vehicles. The mobile radar system is equipped with the different type of, what is the LIDAR technology? Just I tell you, this is a fire of the laser rays. This fires the laser rays and receives the laser and the signature, and we get a three-dimensional map of an area with the accurate coordinates with this. So this is a new technology in the field of the remote sensing and geospatial. And there are three types of technologies there: mobile LIDAR, terrestrial LIDAR, and then comes to UAV based technology system. The UAV based also, we have must have a radar technology and UAV based photogrammetric sensors also we can put on the satellites, on the UAV and the fixed wing air photograph also. Then we can map any area the real time basis. This is the new venture in our center. Thanks. This type of maps is normally generated with the radar technology of a contour based of the centimeter accuracy. Of 10 centimeter accuracy contours, which is the prime requirement of the area, and many areas in the UP where we can map the 10 centimeter, 10, 1 meter, 50 centimeter accuracy is the most demanding feature in the planning purpose. Next. This is the satellite photographs. This is the LIDAR technology, the photograph taken by the LIDAR and superimposed the laser rays on that, the point cloud data on that photograph taken by the LIDAR equipment. If you see that, suppose you have to widen a road, how much tree, how much building, how much path you have to cut. So these are actually we can see on the ground, and actually we can map within a few hours or few seconds, or maybe in a 15 days period we can complete the entire process. Next. Another equipment is there, which is called the underwater survey, that is called the bathymetric survey instrument, and this is called a sonar survey instrument. We as you know that we can pass the sonar waves underground, underwater, and we receive the signal and we can get the depth of the water in any canal, reservoir, and river also. So this is the equipment recently we have bought in our center, and which is the first in India and the only center inland water authority is having this type of equipment in India. So we are second in the India to have this type of instrument. The LIDAR also, state government is the only state government department in India which is having the LIDAR technology. So this instrument gives you the actually the siltation purpose. Suppose regularly monitoring of the underwater survey, we give the rate of siltation in the water, whether reservoir, whether it is a canal system or river system. Next. Now this is the data captured from the sonar waves. Sonar waves comes, and the data is gathered. This is a Pampika, this is a Indra canal, where we have done the survey of 10 km length, we have done the survey, and this shows the depth of the water in the canal system. And the accuracy of the system is also GPS fitted. Also, we have the centimeter accuracy of the system. So 10 centimeter, 10, 12 centimeter or 5 centimeter accuracy is now. What we are talking about earlier is the meter accuracy. Now we have to come down to the centimeter accuracy.